وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى in today session I want to cover the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where he says
وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ الْأَرْضُ الْمَيْتَةُ أَحْيَيْنَاهَا وَأَخْرَجْنَا مِنْهَا حَبًّا فَمِنْهُ يَأْكُلُونَ وَجَعَلْنَا فِيهَا جَنَّاتٍ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَأَعْنَابٍ وَفَجَّرْنَا فِيهَا مِنَ الْعُيُونَ لِيَأْكُلُوا مِن ثَمَرِهِ وَمَا عَمِلَتْهُ أَيْدِيهِمْ أَفَلَا يَشْكُرُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمِنْ آيَاتٍ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ. Allah says, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ الْأَرْضُ الْمَيْتَةُ أَحْيَيْنَاهَا. يعني the word الآية, it means sign. يعني العلامة والدلالة أما والدلالة. The signs of Allah تبارك وتعالى. As Allah mentioned سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Al-Baqarة, He says, إِنَّ آيَةَ مُلْكِهِ أي عَلَامَةَ مُلْكِهِ. That's what the word آيَة means. آيَة means العلامة, means a sign. Okay? And it means indications as well. From the signs of Allah تبارك وتعالى is وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ الْأَرْضُ الْمَيْتَةُ أَحْيَيْنَهَا. The earth, after it becomes barren and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala destroys all the vegetations on it, He gives it life again. It's a sign of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. As the poet said, فَوَعَجَبًا كَيْفَ يُعْصَى الْإِلَاهُ أَمْ كَيْفَ يَجْحَدُهُ الْجَاحِدُ وَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ آيَةٌ تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاحِدُ. How can Allah be disobeyed? Fascination, wonder. How can Allah be disobeyed subhanahu wa ta'ala? كيف يعصى الإله. How can Allah be disobeyed subhanahu wa ta'ala? أم كيف يجحده الجاحد. Or how can someone be stubborn in not believing in Allah's existence? How could that happen? And look at this. He says وفي كل شيء له آية. In everything there's a sign تدل على أنه واحد, which shows Allah is one subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what it means here وآية لهم, it means أي للناس جميعا, a sign for all of the people. لهم أي للناس جميعا, for all of us. Which shows what دالة على وجود الخالق. That shows Allah exists سبحانه وتعالى. It doesn't only والله just show that. قسما لمن أحل القسم. I swear by the one who permitted swearing by him. It doesn't only just show his existence سبحانه وتعالى. All of the things around us show that he, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he is alone in his rububiyah, he is alone in his uluhiyah, he is complete subhanahu wa ta'ala. It shows his complete infinite strength and ability subhanahu wa ta'ala. وحدانيته في ربوبيته وألوهيته وكمال عظمته. All of that it shows. وقدرته على إحياء الموتى. It even shows how Allah تبارك وتعالى can give life to the dead. وسعة علمه. It shows how vast His knowledge is سبحانه وتعالى when we look at everything. وحكمته. How His wisdom. When we ponder on the signs around us. ورحمته ونعمته and His mercy سبحانه وتعالى and the blessings that He has bestowed upon us. This ayah, الأرض الميتة أحييناها, نافع عن أبو جعفر, they recited it as الميتة بتشديد الياء. They place a shadda on the ياء. وقرأ الباقون بتخفيفها and the other remaining قراء, they recited it as الميتة. Whereas نافع عن أبو جعفر, they recited it as الميتة. Okay, that's how they recited. But the meaning is one. Okay, there's no different in meaning. Inshallah ta'ala. يعني it means الأرض الهامدة اليابسة. The earth which has يعني Allah تبارك وتعالى stripped from it vegetations and Allah تبارك وتعالى took from it any, what do you call it, يعني, made it into a barren ground, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gives it life by what? بإنزال المطر عليها, by sending rain onto it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Hajj.
فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ.
Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ, when we send down the rain on it,
اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ وَأَنبَتَتْ مِن كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ.
As soon as Allah sends those rains, subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a means where it's a way Allah tabarak wa ta'ala brings back the vegetation and the greenery and the fruits and all of it back to the earth. That's what he means.
أَحْيَيْنَاهَا أَي بِالنَّبَاتَاتِ
وَالْأَشْجَارِ بِإِنزَالِ الْمَطَرِ عَلَيْهَا بَعْدَ أَنْ كَانَتْ يَابِسَةً. After the earth became barren and there was no vegetations or fruits on it, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave it life by bringing plants, vegetations, fruits, greenery. And he brought, subhanahu wa ta'ala, rain to bring all of that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the here, brothers and sisters, you would find this very common in the Quran, where Allah compares the earth, the cycle it goes through. The land becomes barren, it dies, and then Allah sends rain down, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then it gives it life again, and that cycle. Allah is telling us that cycle you see there is also similar in the human cycle. That the human beings, when they also perish and they die, Allah is able to resurrect them just the same way He's able to resurrect the earth. The same way He can give life back to that earth, He's also able to give life to the humans. Allah does that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see that a lot in the Quran. For example, in Surah Fussilat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says,
وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنَّكَ تَرَى الْأَرْضَ خَاشِعَةً فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ إِنَّ الَّذِي أَحْيَاهَا لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى إِنَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ.
Allah talks about the earth, how He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes the land, يعني ميت, takes life out of it. It becomes a barren land. It becomes a barren ground, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then He sends down, فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ. When we send down the rain, there you go. It gives it life again. هَيَّ إِنَّ الَّذِي أَحْيَاهَا, the one that gave life to that earth after it became barren, إِنَّ الَّذِي أَحْيَاهَا لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. He is the one who's able to give life to the creation when they pass away and when they die. He's the one who's able to resurrect them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ أي Allah عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah has ability over everything alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He mentions, He says,
وَأَخْرَجْنَا مِنْهَا حَبَّا.
Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, we bring out from this earth, وَأَخْرَجْنَا مِنْهَا حَبًّا. حَبًّا here, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made it nakira. Means جَمِعْ أَصْنَافِ الْحُبُوبِ. All of the different seeds that come out of this earth. يعني حنطة, you know, شعير, barley, يعني all of them, everything, wheat, and all of it. Allah brings it out, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why does He send it? Why does He do all of that, subhanahu wa ta'ala? رزق لكم. It's a risk for all of us. And He wants to bestow His blessing on us. Allah then says, فَمِنْهُ يَأْكُلُونَ. فَمِنْهُ يَأْكُلُونَ. يعني Allah, what He did here is قدم المعمول لإفادة الحصر. The sequence and the order of the sentence has been put back to front. For what reason? Like it, لإفادة الحصر, so exclusivity can come. ومراعاة للفاصلة, which here it means فمنه يأكلون وهم وأنعامهم. They eat from it. Not only their cattle also eat from it as well. Allah mentions it, Surah Abasa. He says,
فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ أَنَّا صَبَبْنَا الْمَاءَ صَبَّا ثُمَّ شَقَقْنَا الْأَرْضَ شَقَّا فَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا حَبَّا وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا وَزَيْتُونًا وَنَخْلًا وَحَدَائِقَ غُلْبًا وَفَاكِهَةً وَأَبًّا مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ.
All of that is for you to enjoy. And it's also for your cattle. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He also says in Surah Qaf, Surah Al-Nazi'at, he says, وَالْأَرُضَ بَعْدَ ذَٰلِكَ دَحَاهَا أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاءَهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا وَالْجِبَالَ أَرْسَاهَا مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ Surah Qaf, he says similar, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ وَالنَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ رِزْقًا لِلْعِبَادِ وَأَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ The way that Allah gave life to that earth after it was a barren ground, كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ Like that, it will be the resurrection. That's how the resurrection is going to be. Allah went on to say, وَجَعَلْنَا فِيهَا جَنَّاتٍ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَأَعْنَابٍ Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says, وَجَعَلْنَا We made in it. في تلك الأرض, this earth, that part that died, الميتتي, Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says, we made inside it. What did we make inside it? يعني فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب, يعني from trees and grapes and all of that, سبحانه وتعالى. يعني with, the trees are not without leaves. They have everything. Okay? وفجرنا فيها من العيون. And Allah تبارك وتعالى, He said, we brought out of the earth. What is it? عيون. عيون is water that comes and flows, and سبحانه وتعالى. Rivers and lakes and streams and all of that. He did it on the earth, سبحانه وتعالى. ليأكلوا من ثمره. So they can eat from it vegetations and the fruits that are from it. Hamza and Kisa'i and Khalaf, they read as ثمره. That's how they read it. بضم التائي. They place, sorry, بضم الثائي. Place a dhamma on the tha. And also on the meme, whereas the other remaining qurra, they recited as thamari. The lam in liyakulu min thamari, that lam is called lam ta'lil. Ay liajli an yakulu min liajli an yakulu min thamar min thamarihi qutan wa adaman. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He place all of these vegetations and all of this so the people can eat from it. The fruits on the earth, all of it, Allah Tabaraka wa ta'ala did it for. Fakiha, ladda, Allah. وَمَا عَمِلَتُ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا عَمِلَتُ أَيْدِيهِمْ Hamza and Kisa'i and Khalaf and Abu Bakr and Asim, they recited as without the ha. عَمِلَتْ بِدُونِهَا There's no ha in it. Like the other remaining qurra, they affirm the ha. So they say عَمِلَتْهُ عَمِلَتْهُ Who they place that ha. And that ha is a dhamir, it's a pronoun, right? So where does that pronoun go back to? A'idun ila al-madhkur. It goes back to what was just mentioned right now, which is al-hab, yo al-nakhil, yo al-a'nab, sorry. It goes back to that. The waw in wa ma'amilatu aydihimna, it's waw haliya. Ay wal halu anna dhalika thamar. The situation is that these vegetations and these fruits is ma amilatu aydihim, that which their hands have worked toward. وَالْحَالُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ ثَمَرْ مَا عَمِلَتُ أَيْدِيهِمْ It's what their hands have done, okay? The waw in وَمَا عَمِلَتُ أَيْدِيهِمْ It's حَالِيَة أي وَالْحَالُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ ثَمَرْ That these vegetations and these fruits which they are eating is not what they have created and they made it. No, they didn't. They didn't have any hand in making it. Allah is the one who made it. Because the majority of the things that they're eating from the earth is that which you can just take and eat directly. It doesn't require cooking or anything. And the humans don't make it, it's what Allah makes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? That's one meaning. Some scholars, they said, وَمَا عَمِلَتُ أَيْدِيهِمْنَا The ma'in wa ma'amilat wa aydim. The first one would be a negation. The second one, some scholars, they said it's a mawsoola. It's a connective. Ma'atufun ala thamarihi. It's connected to thamarihi. في محل جر, which means ويأكلون, they eat من الذي عملته أيديهم, they eat from that which their hands have made. So Allah تبارك وتعالى, He is يعني mentioning His favors onto them, how He brought out vegetations from the earth, ready made, and also fruits that they, if you take the موصولة معطوفة على ثمرهنا, some that they have to cook, but it was made for them to cook it, and some of them were made not for them to cook. Allah تبارك وتعالى already, Allah then says أفلا يشكرون. The istifham of أفلا يشكرون is called istifham للإنكار. Is أفلا يشكرون الله الذي, are they not going to show Allah تبارك وتعالى gratitude سبحانه وتعالى على ما أنعم به عليهم من هذه النعم العظيمة, how He has bestowed upon them these great blessings سبحانه وتعالى. This is called استفهام للإنكار. How could you not show gratitude to the Lord who done all of this for you سبحانه وتعالى. I'm going to stop there inshallah وتعالى. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.